Oh, we need to resolve this, don't we? Well, I guess to kick us off today, we're gonna have Shane McMahon take on Earl Hebner for the hardcore title. Something seems wrong here. Yeah, something's wrong here. Well, good for Stone Cold Steve Austin in a fucking front row seat to this event. Now, okay, I gotta see something. Ah! We'll turn the difficulty down. Well, since Mr. Austin wanted a fucking match so much, I'll be taking on the former hardcore champion who did not get his rematch for reasons. How is this prick? Now come out exactly how you dressed, asswipe.
Thank you.
Should have stayed where you were, Steven.
Uh-oh.
What is this fucking pedophile Crash Holly doing out here? Or is that hardcore? I can't even remember. Now that looks like Crash. Wow, that's fucking lame. Which one of you cucks was it? Was it hardcore or Crash? It was Crash. Well, fuck you too, buddy. All right, moving on.
Time for the pay-per-view fight we never got. What? Oh. Fucking go away. Okay, there we go. Now let's beat his ass. After all this bullshit to set it up. Oh, shit. Damn it. Flew too close to the sun there. Well, WCW wins, but now I just want to beat his ass. You bitch. I had that scouted. Oh, shit. Shit. God damn it, fine. God damn it, fine, you win. You win, Eric. Okay? My hubris was a little too fucking much. This is a fucking disaster.
And the Bulls go through their pregame routine. It's the home of the Bulls.
You know, looking around, he knew one of his teammates was going to be open when they hit him with that double team, and he took advantage.
Well, the Timberwolves looking to get a win here on the road. And last season, that was a major, major issue for them. In fact, only one team, the Wizards, had a worse record on the road.
Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Guys, I had a chance to catch up with the Minnesota Timberwolves head coach. In terms of their defensive attitude coming into this one, he said, "We've been protecting the rim very well at that end of the floor, and that's something I want to see continue today." Guys?
Thanks, Doris. Well, guys, give us your thoughts on that.
I can't fucking believe that.
A lot of teams, really good teams, start with good teams. So it's pretty much what I
can't fucking believe
that. For this club, that's the way it should be. I mean, they need to send a message defensively right away. When you take it to your opponents on the defensive end of the floor, it sets the tone really.
I mean, there are a lot of things that you need to look at trying to answer that. It starts with taking care of the ball. Timberwolves had the most turnovers of anybody in the league. And on the road, you've got to really value it. I mean, that's one way you have a chance to win on the road is if you maximize possessions and don't turn it over.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Gibson comes in for Carlos Boozer. And Lonnie Brewer subbed in for Keith Bogans. Here's Bekovic. Here's Johnson. No good on the triple. And so here's Chicago. On its way from Rose for two. And Gibson kicks to Rose. Jacks up a three. Rose can't get that one to fall.
You've got to be fucking
now
with
the
me.
Timberwolves with it.
We're seriously doing this shit again, Derek? Are we seriously doing this shit again? When you can't hit dick? That is a terrifying face. Jesus Christ, fucking Aryan shit right there. That's awful.
Timberwolves on D. How about the Bulls' improvement a year ago, guys? They won 62 games, up from 41 in the previous year. Once again, Chicago has become a dominant team.
And a chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor. All fueled up and ready to go for the start of the second quarter. So on the floor for Minnesota. Beasley plays the three with Love and Darko rounding out the plan. He crushes it through. Strikes Lamcam with the replay.
Well, that's a dunk you will not see very often. You won't pass that one by.
No doubt about that.
I wish he would, though. You'd never see too many of those.
And here's Porter from the arc. And that's collected by Love.
How about the season Kevin Love had a year ago? He put up numbers that we haven't seen in a long time. Had a 30-30 game. Huge rebound totals. And it just continued all season long.
Rose passes to a shoot. Rose kicks the Bogut. Fires from deep.
How did you fucking miss again? How did he fucking miss again?
Now, here's Rubio. He's covered by Rose. Easily outside. Pocket six. Fades away. And a hit. Chicago takes it the other way.
Both clubs really battling under the board. Yeah, and you know, Steve, the rebounding story really mirrors the game at large. I mean, it's been pretty much tit for tat, neck and neck.
Loser kicks to Rose. Three-pointer.
Of course. Why did I think that was going to go down? It was only fucking wide open. There was nobody within 20 goddamn yards of him. Why did I think he had enough fucking clearance to make a shot in a goddamn basketball game?
And he makes both free throws.
Fuck it.
Timberwolves lead by four.
And we got a fun one going on.
Speak for yourself, Ken.
Well, both sides have assessed what they need to do over the break in halftime. We'll see now if one can pull out away here in the third. Here is Rose. Still looking to get on the scoreboard.
You know, the Timberwolves were only 10-20 against the East last season. They say the West is a dominant conference, but not when you're talking about the Timberwolves. They were a tough team.
Rose is flanked by Bogans in the backcourt. Duraldang and Carlos Boozer, they're the forward shots. And it's Noah in at the foul, and in the paint. So that's who Tom Thibodeau starts the second half with. And let's now go to the sideline and catch up here with Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, guys, there was a time when some in Chicago were concerned they overpaid for Duraldang. But don't count Coach Tom Thibodeau among us. He said he's a professional and works hard every day. He can score in a number of different ways. He's unselfish. He gives himself up for the team. He's very effective without the ball. He's got a terrific mid-range game. He's better in the post than most people give him credit for. And he's becoming a confident shooter. Sounds like he brings a lot to the table.
Yeah, he can do it all. Thanks, Doris. Well, for the Timberwolves, they've never managed 25 wins in the four seasons since they traded away Kevin Garnett. Steve, how long do you think it's going to take to rebuild this team?
Well, unfortunately, it looks like it's going to be a long time because building block you can say they have is Kevin Love. We'll see how Ricky Rubio does. We'll see if any of these young draft picks
pick
up this year can improve this team.
should have seen that coming.
Seems to me they're still at least a couple of years away.
Rose against Ribnauer. Let's it go with a three. Rebound Minnesota. Love's got four rebounds in this game. Easy shot. And there's Ribnauer. That's good on the assist from Wesley Johnson. Ribnauer's got 8 points. And here's Rose outside.
This is your main event, by the way. Thank you. Was this actually on one difficulty? Ah, I knew it. Well, let's have our actual main event then. Oh my god, I'm getting my ass kicked. This feels even higher. What the fuck? Yeah, my fucking asshole shredded by Batman. I'm gonna beat this prick. Oh, not with shit like that happening. Damn it. I'm not convinced that this wasn't on 4 again. Okay, one more go at it. I'm not convinced this wasn't on 4. See, there we go again. What the fuck? One more. Alright, okay. We need to reevaluate something here. Thank you. Well, now I feel like I can actually do something here, so that's good. Not really a great match, but we're getting somewhere here. I only got the damn thing. Damn it. This is fucking exhausting.
Oh, shit. So did that stay on one? That's what I want to know. It was a fine match. I'll let that be the main event, sure. But... oh, I guess it just resets every time? That's weird and annoying. I wish that wouldn't happen. Because I needed to see. But, okay. So, I'm going to take a guess that the first two weren't. And that one was. That's my best guess here. Anyway,